rock a night out, we rock a night out, y'all. We rock a night out, we rock a night out, y'all. We rock a night out, we rock a night out, y'all. Call the boy, you know, my shit, y'all, y'all. My shit, we're hungry, Dodge. Never have to see the possibility of prophecy, Jesus' word is sincerity and truth. His name from God's freedom and new tongue. Into the hope for a land, into the confusion, faith, and the joy of the tribe, right? Into the heart, kept my eye, watched it, I listened and learned it. To you, I said, shout out to all. Brother Kennedy, we're coming at you with another lesson entitled You Good Is Evil Spoken Of. And the title of the lesson, you know, prompts in my mind to think of how wicked and how corrupt that this society is. And the things that you do which are righteous in the eyes of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, that are well evil spoken of. For example, you know, example is that when you celebrate the feast days, which is like, you know, like the Passover, the Purim, and all the other feast days that the Most High commands us to, you know, in this society, that doing that is evil spoken of. But, you know, you turn around, you celebrate Christmas and Halloween, Thanksgiving and birthdays and 4th of July and all these other types of madness. You know, they look at that as being righteous. And you celebrate the feast day, they look at that as something evil. The scripture also say the good is going to be evil spoken of. Meaning that, you know, you are right in the eyes of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah, you know, you're going to be spoken evil. And also, it says in the scriptures that, you know, your name will be cast off as evil when you're doing righteousness. You know, something to that effect. It's that, you know, no matter the righteousness that you do in the eyes of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah, you know, where you keep in law, statutes, commandments, you out there on the highway and byway teaching and doing the work. And you putting out the pistol on YouTube and you waking up the hope for that. Everything that you doing according to will you hide by Shem Yahweh Shah is going to be evil spoken of. But you know, you still got to continue to do what's right in the eyes of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shah. Because we got to remember that our reward is in the kingdom of heaven. And scripture also said that, you know, Yahweh Shah said, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according to as the word should be. Meaning, no matter if your evil has been spoken of, how shall reward is going to be with him? And everybody can give according to the word be. And for those, you know, scoff at the men of the Lord, then out there on the highways and byways teaching the truth, are you ready? You come on the brother's lessons and you decide that you want to scoff and make fun. Guess what? Well, you know, guess what? We're not worried about that. Because we know that righteous in the eyes of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, is bringing out this truth. You know, it's bringing out these epistles. You know, break them down the correct way according to the spirit of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. And we know that they're coming with the territory with scoffers. You know, they're going there and saying that, you know, the Hebrew Israelite hateful. You know, they terrorists. All because we bring out the scriptures. You got the so-called, you know, Esau Edom, which is the so-called white man, to go and bomb countries and take landmarks by force. And yet you the same energy that you give to the Hebrew Israelites, you know, being the Lord that's speaking the truth, you want bring that energy, same energy to Esau Edom. This man raped, robbed, lied, murdered, pilgrimage, going there, taking landmarks, you know, Venezuela, you know, fucking with the other countries, bullying them, bringing their democracy, trying to bring their democracy over there. They done all these wicked things. But yet, you know, you're not even outcrying against that. But when up in the Lord bringing out the scriptures, and talks about the wickedness of this land, and you demonize us. You demonize us, you know, on the media. And then you got these stupid pastors that come on live and try to call themselves doing lessons against the Hebrew Israelites, talking about you know, it's a 911 emergency. You know, what 911 emergency? And, you know, in these pastors, you know, they lose a member. And they lose that tithe and offering money. And by them losing that tithe and offering money, you know, now they revert to the tithe. The Hebrew Israelites are, you know, they teaching false doctrine. You know, slandering the men of the Lord. You know, scripture, scripture said that, you know, your good's gonna be even spoken of. Nose kind of stopped up this morning. But yeah, your good is even spoken of. And you got these pastors that are out there, you know, calling the 911 emergency because they lose their members, they lose their tithe and offer money. Now it's forcing them to make videos demonizing the Israelites. And we all know that this is gonna happen. Because these devils, man, they mad and upset because they lose money. They lose their king. He loses his king. He's going to use the media trying to demonize us. They said that we're the cause of why the society of America is falling. Guess what? We're not the cause of your society falling. It's your house by Shem Yahushua. Gave you a set time that your kingdom is going to fall. You know? And all the time your kingdom falling, trying to demonize the Hebrew Israelites and trying to say that we are terrorists, we're hateful. You know, we're the reason why your kingdom is crumbling, but you know that we're not the reason. Yahweh Shem Yahusha is. Yeah, well, you know, that's neither here nor there. Because we know that what we do is even spoken of, because we're living in righteousness. So you how about Shem Yahusha? You know, for example, our Shabbat goes according to the full moon. Wherever the full moon falls under that month, that's when we serve our Shabbat. But yeah, you turn around and say that, you know, that's wickedness of what we're doing. But yeah, you go to the harder houses on Sunday, you know, which fall out to the sun god Tammuz. But your way is evil. Your ways are evil according to Yahweh Hashem Yahusha. But yeah, you turn around and say, because we doing what Yahweh Hashem Yahusha said to the best of our ability. You look at our ways as something evil. Because we live according to what the scripture said, not according to what man said. We live according to what Yahweh Hashem Yahusha said, but not your master Esau. Master Esau is the one that, you know, really changed the signs of the times and everything else, saying that, worshiping, Jesus is going to be on Sunday and come up with a resurrection Sunday, which is Easter, you know, which a lot of your dummies out there are going to go out and celebrate anyway. And, you know, the question is, what in the hell does the Cadbury Bunny and the Easter egg, well, the egg got to do with the resurrection of the Savior. celebrate the Passover before the scriptures. The righteous work we're doing is even spoken of. And these devils hate it, man. You people hate it because you know that what we're doing is really Yahweh Yahushua. And the will is for us to keep the law, statutes, and commandments to the best of our ability. And to forsake Babylon and ungrateful. And to forsake the wickedness of this planet. And to serve Yahweh Yahushua to the best of our ability through the spirit of Ruach HaKodesh. But you know, that's neither here nor there. But we know that your kingdom is going to be destroyed. The kingdom of Esau is going to be destroyed. Because all the wickedness is going to have to be purged off of this planet. So all the wickedness in the world got to be purged. But you know, you people, you people love to promote wickedness. You know, everything that's righteous and holy, you saying that that's evil. But all the wickedness that you want in the world, you saying that, you know, they're good. You saying that it's good for two homosexual men or women to get together. According to scriptures, you know, they're supposed to be put to death. But according to y'all saying that, you know, that's a righteous thing, you know. You're fringing on their laws. Guess what? They don't have no laws, man. Their laws is governed by Yahweh Shem Yahushua. But I forgot. And if you're not Israelite, you're not going to follow laws that you command because they won't give it to you in the first place. Because you look at the laws as something evil. Because the law would tell a woman that she don't even supposed to wear that which pertains to a man. And a man don't even supposed to wear a woman's garment because it's an abomination. And I'll see how about Jimmy out shop. But then you turn around and look at that's infringing on our rights. We got rights to do this, we got rights to do that. But then you'll expect Yahweh Shimmy Hasha to bless America. Yahweh Shimmy Hasha is not with America. Because America is the most wickedest kingdom on the face of the planet. You know, America push out their philosophies. They evil democracy, they evil philosophy. But we have to teach them according to the scriptures of Yahweh Shimmy Hasha. Y'all look at that, it's hate speech. That's the reason why y'all sent up there going to ban the Bible. You know, you want to go out here, you pass laws and try to ban the Bible, and you going on YouTube saying that, you know, you got to have 1,000 members, subscribers, to even go live. You know, all this madness. But yeah, you got people that promote wickedness, you ain't put no stipulation on them. They out there pushing homosexuality. They out there pushing bestiality. They can have sex with their dogs and all types of nonsense. And yeah, you ain't going to tell them that they need 1,000 subscribers to go live. But yeah, you tell the men of the Lord who ain't even doing wickedness, who out there pushing the gospel of Yahweh Shimmy out shop, that they got to have 1,000 subscribers to go live. Like the scripture said, that the truth is going to be even spoken of. But you people love to push wickedness. You people love to push iniquity. That's the reason why this kingdom will have to come down. And the kingdom is going to be destroyed with a heavy judgment by Yahweh Shem Yahusha. Because the worst on this planet are evil. You know, worst in Babylon the Great are evil. And the foundation of the earth is out of course. You know, they're jacking up the weather. They do all types of wickedness. But ain't nobody having no outcry against them. Nobody ain't signing a crime, you know, over this wickedness. Okay, where the damn Christians at? Where the damn Christians at when it comes down to homosexuality? You don't hear shit out of these Christians. You know, you don't hear a damn word out of these Christians. And these folks are just doing wickedness. On top of wickedness. And you don't hear no outcry about it. But yeah, the men of the Lord out there, they're teaching the word of Yahweh Shimmy Hasha, and know, putting out epistles, you know, condemning the witness of Babylon the Great. And yet, you got these pastors coming away with a problem with what we teach, even though we teach it out the scripture. Even though that you got brothers that's bringing out historical facts. Lining up with scripture and the prophecy fulfilled itself according to the scriptures. You turn around and you got all this energy to go against the men of the Lord, which we know that your ass is corner anyway. You got a carnal mindset. You know, you got a carnal wicked mindset. Because Most High ain't gave you that spiritual eye. You know, that spirit, the spirit of Ruach HaKodesh, that spirit not given to you to see what's going on. But you said that what we talk about, what we're teaching is evil, even though we bring it out from the scriptures. You know, your good is going to be evil spoken of, the truth is evil spoken of. But, you know, you got people who sit there and push out a lie for it, and then they will push out the truth. A lie get more publicity than the truth ever will. You know, they doing everything that they can to try to suppress the truth. You know, they it's gonna become a time it's gonna be the famine of the word. But it don't matter, bring it on, devil. Bring it on, you damn devil. Because once you shut the internet down, and when people shut down, and once you start the famine of the word, that lets them know that the spirit, the hopefully, or Yahweh Shimmy House Shot is sealed. That's it. That right there will clear your demise, especially for you damn Christians. You know, I pray that Yahweh Shimmy House Shot start closing these damn harder houses down. I'm talking about just literally closing them down because they ain't did nothing but promote wickedness. That's all they ever did. They caused our people to go further and further away from the law, statutes, and commandments of Yahweh Shimmy House Shot. And I pray that Yahweh Shimmy House Shot would just start closing down these harlot houses. I'm talking these churches that start closing down left and right. You know, they just start closing down and have padlocks put on. Because these pastors ain't bringing out no scriptures. They ain't bringing out no truth. You know, they want to go against the men of the Lord who are bringing out righteousness, who are bringing out the truth, and waking up the hope for a living. And trying to warn our stupid ass people to repent and come back to the law, statute, and commandments of Yahweh Shimmy House Shot. And they refuse to. They want to stay in Christianity. That raised why two-thirds of our people are going to be cut off on their side. Because they refuse to hear the truth. They look at as the truth is something evil. You know, our people, you know, they don't know how to do righteousness. You know, two-thirds of our people, they quit to do evil, but the righteousness, they don't know how to be righteous. You know, they don't want to be righteous. They want to save the so-called white man, Esau the Edom, which we know in the scripture that there's no salvation for them. That's throughout the scripture. But yeah, our people are still that dumb enough to go out there and try to save them. You know, scripture makes it clear that these Edomites can't be saved. But when you tell them that, they're looking at that what you're saying is something evil, even though it's backed up by the scripture. But you know, that's it for the lesson. You know, what I'm praying out that the truth is evil spoken of. And you're going to see more things that are going to come out against the truth. That's going to be evil spoken of. It's going to come out against the men of the Lord. And they're going to come to the point that they're going to shut down YouTube. They're going to outlaw the Bible saying there's a it's a hate book. And they're going to say that Hebrew is like a hate group. And they will teach a hate speech, even though the Ku Klux Klan can say white power and can burn our people to the damn state. They can do whatever. But that they look at that as something righteous. But look at us, we bring out scriptures. It's something evil. But you know, that's it for this. All praise to the Most High, Yahweh, Shimmy House Shah, Shimmy HaKadosh, double honor to the apostle, elder, the prophet, bringing out the truth and sincerity, reaching their lives for freedom to do so to the hope for elect, and to the confusion of faces, and also to the Akim and the Akwa that are listening and learning. Until next time, Yahweh willing, Shalom.